Narwade from Python in India, Bangalore.
Yes.
He's going to talk to us about Kompose.
Yeah.
Thanks, Suraj.
Yeah, thanks. So, hi, I'm Suraj Narwade. That's about me. I work at Red Hat. I contribute to project and the cage, and my life revolves around Kubernetes and OpenShift, and in meanwhile Alexa. And yeah, if you want to contact me, that's my contact details, and you can find my blogs at suraj.pro. Yeah, let's start with the talk. So you might heard the terms containers, orchestration, Kubernetes. That means like everyone wants to containerize their applications, right? So like someone like you go to some conference and heard terms microservices, containers, and they went back and like, hey, let's do microservice, let's containerize the application. So first thing you want to do is you will learn Docker, right? So-called MUBI, yeah. Then you do Docker run and some application, and you get started, right? You deploy your first Docker application. But what if you have a more than Docker run two times? Okay, but that's not feasible. You cannot do those things in production, right? Or even it's not feasible to do it locally. Then it was a Docker Compose, right? So the same thing you mentioned earlier with the two Docker run, you can mention with the in one YAML file, like image name, environment variable, volumes and all. But your developer is happy now, okay, but not for so long, because one does not simply deploy containers to the production, right? You need some kind of container orchestration, you need some kind of management, right? So as I said, like Docker Compose, it's good for local development but not for production, right? So container orchestrators, so there are multiple container orchestrator: Kubernetes, Docker Swarm, Mesos. But since this is a Kubernetes talk, I'm wearing Kubernetes t-shirt. I'll talk about production ready container orchestrator, Kubernetes. So why Kubernetes? It's a robust, it's coming from the Google's production experience, which is Borg, and it has a huge community around it. So you get a very decent support. But at the same time, the developers has a problem. There's a huge learning curve. You have to learn all the basic things like pods, services, deployment, replicas, and all. And developers don't want to learn those things, right? So remember the Docker Compose, your developer learned Docker Compose before to just get started with the containers, right? So where's the investment? Like you invested some time with Docker Compose, right? And now you have to get started with Kubernetes. See, your Docker Compose file was just 8 to 10 lines, and here's the Kubernetes, it's ending down as well. So here's the solution, Compose. So what Compose does, it gives you the power to deploy your Docker Compose onto the Kubernetes, okay? So why Compose? So it will transition you from Docker Compose to Kubernetes. The default generated by the Compose may be the quick start for you, maybe the base, it gives you the base manifest for you to deploy. It will not be 100% for you, but you will be 95% way there on Kubernetes. So what were the main use cases? Main use cases were like testing your cluster in dev environment maybe, because what I saw that most of the developers use Docker Compose only for their local development. Creating POCs, simplifying Kubernetes deployment. And what I think is like, if your application is going to deploy in Kubernetes, you should do Kubernetes native development, right? So you can use that for that thing. So the features we have added, so we added Docker Compose version 3 support as well, and now we are trying to add the latest version as well, which is 3.2 and later on. We have build and push support. Let's say you have a build key, I'll show that demo now. And we support the other controller as well. We have YAML, JSON, both support, because I heard from the people that most of the ops guys hates YAML file due to indentation and all. So we have JSON as well, and we support OpenShift as well. And integrations, how many of you are familiar with Maven plugin or Fabricate? Yeah, so we have an integration with Fabricate Maven plugin as well in Red Hat Dev Suite. And other very cool integrations are there under our website. And roadmap, so we are trying to support as much key as possible, because Docker also trying to simplify the experience. So we have some keys in the Docker Compose which now directly map and UX. But before that, I want to tell something different. There are some limitations for the Compose, right? Like, because Docker Compose was initially made for the local development or a Docker swarm, so there are some limitations, like you cannot create stateful set, jobs, volumes are difficult to create. So you can check conversion matrix on our website under conversion page. So we have done all those things, like which key maps to what and all. And what next, actually? So the next is we learned some lessons from the Compose that we cannot go 100% towards the Kubernetes from Docker Compose. So we started a new project, Catch. It's a yet another project which starts with K, because everything in Kubernetes ecosystem starts with K and it's related to Ocean. So what's Catch? It's a simple and easy way to deploy applications. You define only things you needed, and it's not limited to developer. You can extend it as well. So this is the cage. This is the big YAML of Kubernetes. Again, the same. I will not go in much detail, because tomorrow at CentOS Dojo, I'm presenting the cage. So you can find me there, and to know more about cage, you can join me. And these are the resources for the Compose. Recently, we graduated from incubator to Kubernetes org. So now we are under Kubernetes org. That's a website, compose.io. For Catch, we have our own org, Catch Project, catchproject.org. And if you want to talk to us, we are on Compose channel on Kubernetes Slack. And for Catch, we have our own Slack. So before going to question, I'll show you some demo of Compose. So I have a very simple Docker Compose file, which has a, is it visible for you all? Yeah. So a very simple service, two service, which is counter, web, and Redis. So let's say if you want to generate Kubernetes artifact, you just have to do compose convert, and you get all those files. Let's check. Web deployment, the all deployments are there, and compose convert steady out. And I haven't given the hyphen F flag, because compose takes the docker compose.yaml by default. And you can check, like, the services deployment, everything is generated. Let's say, so for local purpose, I'm using Minishift. It's a local OpenShift cluster. What's OpenShift? It's also Kubernetes. So to deploy, I simply have to do compose up. And you can see the applications is deployed. You can see here, OCGet pods. They are running. The both are running now. And to access it, I'll go to Minishift console. Web. To access the application, I'll create the route, and yeah, here's my application, right? It's deployed very easily. We didn't have to do anything. We just use our own Docker Compose file, that's it. So let's say you will say, I want a JSON, I hate YAML, okay? So you just have to do hyphen J flag and you get your JSON output. right? You get JSON output. Now I'll show about build and push demo. So this is a normal developer workflow. You have a simple application, app.py. You have a Docker Compose file, which has a build key and the dot, that means the code is in the current directory, and the other Docker file and all, the basic things. First, I will remove the old deployment we have done. So to remove, we just have to do compose down, and it will delete everything. As simple as that. So here, I just have to do again compose up. Now if you see, it says build key detected. That means it knows, compose detects that build key is there and it has to build the image. So it will build the image, it will push it to registry, and then my cluster will pull the new image and it will deploy the things. See, it's running the first two things. And if you check UI as well, it's running there, right? Basically, they were the same thing. That's why you will see the same output, but the different thing. Yeah. And let's say you want to create some other controller, right? So you can do compose convert and see the help. So we have --- controller flag where you can mention deployment or whether a daemon set or a replication controller. Yeah. I still have a few minutes. Yeah, thank you. So quickly, I will show you about. Okay, cache as well. So for deploying the simple application, you just need those lines. So we have added some shortcuts like port mapping. You can see if you have to mention those things in a Kubernetes YAML, they are like port, target port, and everything. So this is cache YAML. Again, you want to generate Kubernetes YAML, just feed the file to it and it will generate the file. Or you want to deploy it in a similar way, cache apply. Yeah, your service and deployment is created. So that was about my demo. Yeah. Oh, something goes wrong. So yeah, questions? Yeah.
So cache is kind of like compose, but it's a bit more isomorphic.
Yeah. So the lesson we learned from the compose was we cannot get 100% way there. So we wrote our own DSL, which is cache. It's a simplified YAML. It's a YAML only, but it's a simplified, and it has some shortcuts as well, which you can easily define the things. And along with that, it's not limited to that only. We are using the same structs from the Kubernetes, so you can extend it. So things like node affinity and all, which are like very high level, ops level stuff, you can also define that there.
Is it production ready?
So cache was made in the keeping in mind that developer will do Kubernetes native development, but yeah, it's pretty much stable. You can give it a try. And if you have any issues, create an issue, send a PR, talk to us on Slack. Any more questions? Any feedbacks? Please check out the projects. Give us the feedback so that we can improve. And tomorrow I'll talk about cache in more depth at CentOS Dojo. Catch me there. And I based on cache, I project interesting surprise project. Just catch me, and I will show you the demo. Thank you.
I just one question about: do you know both for compose and for cache? How many people are using it, and in particular, if
so? Yeah, so currently Kompose, you can see it has around more than 2,000 stars, so lots of people are using it. And so it's just a quick start to you for the Kubernetes. On the catch side, some of my colleagues are using it for their day-to-day stuff, and some of the outside people also using it. They come to our Slack, they ask questions about it. They ask about like whether you will integrate it with something Maven or something like that. Yeah, so there are users.
Okay, yeah, we see that. Yeah,
yeah,
quite a few stars. And when did you start Kedge? How long ago did you start?
So it's been about 8 to 10 months now. Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thanks. Look forward to more on that with interest.
Yeah.
If people want to ask more questions, there's still time. No. Okay, so thanks very much, Suraj.
Thank you.
Appreciate